I'm tired of traveling, or fighting superstition and its many manifestations. Even though it was me who chose to debunk folklore and mysticism, little did I know I'd end up being labeled as Patrick Galloway, the man with endless occult knowledge. Before I knew it, people all over the world paid me to investigate all kinds of weird things. As long as they paid me, I'd look into it. Funny thing though, the more I saw, the more I believe there are forces beyond our control. Creatures not explainable in any human terms. Things that make my skin crawl. I fled from Ireland and hung around Paris and London with no real purpose till the Great War started. I joined a special unit whose job it was to squelch the fears of the superstitious farm boys who made up the fighting ranks. The Dressanti were the biggest pains. We commanded an officer, Jeremiah Covenant, led our unit on the hunt for their camp. We were ambushed. They came streaming out of the woods, waving swords and howling like banshees. I saw their leader holding a strange stone over his head, yelling weird words in a strange tongue. And just when he was gonna pull the trigger, he glared right at me. A bright green flash came from his hand, and it bowled me over as my gun went off. I woke up in a hospital bed with severe burns. They told me Jeremiah and the unit had gone on without me, but he'd given me the shaman stone to keep. I hadn't given any of this much thought until I came back here to find this letter that Jeremiah wrote me almost 6 months ago, asking me to come back to Ireland and help him out. This is not something I'm dying to do, for it may mean the death of me. He saved my life though, so I owe it to him. Just hope it's not too late.
You're Jeremiah's old war buddy, right?
Indeed. Jeremiah's. Sorry it took me so long to get here. His letter said it was most urgent.
Jeremiah is beginning to think that the letter never arrived in your hands. He's been quite anxious to see you. We've all been quite worried. Jeremiah's now bedridden. Follow me and I'll show you to his living quarters. I apologize for the look of the house, but there's only a skeleton crew of servants now. Jeremiah let go of everyone else, and the house is much too large for us to clean. Because we've lost electricity to most parts of the house, we can only maintain the living quarters. This family's had so much tragedy. I hope you can help him.
Thank you. stuck.
Patrick, you made it.
At your service, Jeremiah. Sorry for the delay, but I've been abroad. What happened to you?
It seems I've come under the watchful eye of the Reaper, my friend. It's been a long time, hasn't it?
Apparently too long.
Patrick, I came back from the war only to find my entire estate in disarray. My brother Aaron disappeared first, and then my sister Bethany. My declining health is a result of an old war wound, and unfortunately, the symptoms are irreversible. I didn't summon you here to watch me die. I need your help.
Anything I can do. Just name it.
Strange events began happening around the manor. After thinning out my staff, they ransacked my estate, taking whatever they could carry. The rest of the help was quick to follow, as they feared rumors of my family's curse. I can't help but think it's more than a coincidence that strange happenings have increased since I've been back from the war. I want to get to the bottom of this, but I'm just too weak to investigate it myself. I'm relying on you to step in for me.
Of course, Jeremiah. The only reason I risk coming back here is to assist you however I can.
My thanks to you, Patrick.
What the hell is that?
Sounds like it came from downstairs.
I'll check it out. Lock the door behind me.
Are broken, the world becomes apparent.
Won't budge.
Yeah.
jammed.
Those beasts were after me.
What in God's name were those things?
They're called howlers. And while I've never seen one before tonight, I've heard of them for years.
Those weren't natural, my friend. We're fighting more than superstitions here.
Perhaps I was being naive not to tell you, but there might be something more sinister at work here. When I was a boy, I encountered something I can't quite explain. You see, there was this isle of standing stones that sits just off the estate. Someone had carved a sigil into each of the stones, something indiscernible. Father had many books on the occult, one of which contained a sketch of that very symbol. I took my brothers and sisters out to the island and read from my father's book.
Well, what happened?
Something answered. The ocean began to boil, and a great wind whipped against us as we stood in the circle, and my siblings huddled to the ground in fear. Eventually, the wind died, and the sea settled. Patrick, I know it sounds like the ravings of a dying man, but I believe those standing stones had something to do with this. What has once been a taint upon this family has now begun to manifest itself.
But you told me you're dying. Doesn't this curse end with you?
Who knows? My brothers and sisters are dead, but I don't think they're really gone. I've heard some servants whispering. They think they've seen Lisbeth on the estate. My family has come for me. I sense them, Patrick. By now, you and I know the supernatural exists. You saw the howlers. And what about our encounters with the Tersanti during the war? You still even carry the Gelzebar stone with you.
It's a token of the Shaman's life I took. That's all.
I found a scroll with a picture of the Gelzebar on it. I believe it contains the way to awaken the stone's dormant power.
Very well. Let me study this scroll overnight, and I'll see what I can do in the morning.
This house still hides many secrets. I'm counting on you to reveal them and put an end to this mess.
Have you noticed anything strange going on?
Apparently, Elizabeth's room was broken into last night during the commotion.
Where's her room?
Just down the hall from here. It's quite a mess.
Tell me what you know about Lisbeth.
Why, she was a fetching young lass. Quite the fiery temper, though. She could be placid and calm one minute, and then suddenly she's spitting curses and swinging her nails at you like an animal. Tis a pity her mother died birthing her.
Indeed.
Following her mother's death, I'd raise Lisbeth like my own. In the end, the wasting sickness got her. I'd cared for her when she was sick and watched her wither away to nothing. Pity a young woman has to die in the spring of her life. Now she rests with her poor mother at the family mausoleum. The groundskeeper claims to have seen her recently. Poor man, seeing a ghost is never a good omen.
Where can I find this groundskeeper?
He's out in the gardens. You can get there through the kitchen.
Your knowledge is appreciated. Thank you. Jammed. Jammed. Is that the door to the gardens?
Yes, it is. However, I don't have the key. I lent it to the maid. I believe she's cleaning Aaargh Isinger's room today. It's located in the east wing of the house.
Thanks. I appreciate your help. Stuck. Key. lodge.
Becomes reality. He will rise again. The ritual continues through our blood.